Are you
calling me right now? Hold on.
Okay.
He's controlling it.
Now we live. Now I can see us.
Right. Yeah. It's another edition of the Brown Holy Water Podcast. It's your boy Real Talk Marv. Who I got in the building with me?
Handsome Southside's Finest. Find me where the money at. Y'all ready?
I am Black Success, Coney Island, Brooklyn. Y'all already know what it is. Holla at your boy.
Hi, I'm Star.
That's mad bland.
Star is a friend of the show. Our special guest.
I'm good. Don't worry about that. I'm always messing up something. I'm sorry. DJ Magic, I'm here. I'm just, you know, in the building.
Welcome to the show, brother.
I think that brown water might be kicking on in already. I might, you know.
So I'm starting to feel a little warm and fuzzy. We're going to jump straight into it. You know what I'm saying? Our first topic of the night is pet peeves, you know. What are your pet peeves when it comes to dealing with the opposite sex?
What kind of pet peeves?
Like physical?
You know, a physical turn off.
Teeth.
Let the ladies start.
Teeth and fingernails.
Yo, I'm big on fingernails.
Dirty fingernails might mean that he grinding. You know what I mean?
He's a mechanic, working hard.
You gotta wash your hands.
Might mean he's grinding.
You gotta wash your hands, fam.
Go to bathroom, fam.
That's it? Teeth and fingernails?
Teeth, as far as appearance, teeth, fingernails. And it's something with the nose. Like, I look at, like, the crease.
In the corner where you guys supposed to get the alcohol and get it up in there. Nah, I feel you, fam. Because I'd be the same way.
I need better explanation. Because, you know, brown people, we tend to have a little fuller nose. You know what I'm saying? So please give me a more detail. What do you mean about the nose and the crease and all that?
He knows exactly what I'm talking about.
Can't have the Scottie Pippen.
Yeah.
No, but if you blessed with that funny nose, that's...
I think what she's saying is, is if you have a finger... and you scratch your nose, and there's things in the finger, after you scratch your nose, that's a problem, because I feel it. Slide down a little bit. Okay. Cool.
Perfect.
I think that's what she's talking about.
So you're talking about the residue of scratching on the nose remaining in your fingers?
It's whatever's in the crease. I don't know exactly what it is, but...
dry skin, dry boogers?
It's gook. Like, I don't know.
Like, pus. Like, whatever that is. Yeah, like, whatever that is.
That fingernail.
That had a lot. What else? What don't you like?
I'm going to definitely go with teeth. That's definitely... you got to have some teeth, some nice teeth. At least a smile.
Like, you kind of want to know how is a grown adult walking around with yellow teeth is what you're trying to figure out.
It's possible. Everybody ain't got good dentures.
This is true.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely fingernails. You can't have the dig-in-the-butt fingers. You know when you see like the mildew and the fingers, or when the chicks bite this part right here, chopped up. That shit is disgusting, yo. I won't even let you walk my dog like that, yo. That shit is bad.
I'm just imagining it.
Also, ashy lips, man. You gotta keep your lips moisturized, man. Go get one of the little 99-cent little chapsticks, you know?
You know, to me, what my pet peeves is just like, a woman who don't dress for her size. You know what I'm saying? The woman who... you know, there's nothing wrong being a thicker sister, fuller sister, but, like, you exaggerating. Like, you dress for your aspirations. You dress on how you wish you look and not necessarily how you actually look. You know what I'm saying? That you got to do better. You know what I'm
like
saying?
Like, where they wear the little shirts and all the gut is hanging out a little bit.
Yeah. Like, you're not belly top. It's not... you're not belly top body.
Right.
You know what
That's
I'm saying?
Not
you.
That's not
you know
for
you. You got to accentuate what's your positive attributes, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So if you got the nice chest, in the same, cool, rock a shirt that show your nice chest, but if the belly not part of that combination, shout out to La posted the mean thirst strap earlier. Yo, the ladies was loving it, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, I need also other examples of, like, what's a physical turn off?
Feet.
If they crusty, they're feet. Not done.
Just because it's cold outside don't mean you shouldn't be getting your damn feet done.
Right, yeah. Right. And big feet. NBA
I hate
feet.
When it get cold and then you
No,
know
but you can't control that. I want us to
I'm
really tell
you. Yes, you can.
You can't control if you got an NBA feet.
You get a fake booty. Go to Dr. Miami.
And so get a foot reduction.
Reduce the feet, please. Oh, come on. My baby with a size 5.
They keep that shit like this.
Oh, come on. Feet? I think.
Oh. Well, she with the whole friend. I said, hold on.
I just want to make sure she's good.
She all
right. I
warming up.
I just think. I think another thing is, it's like, you know what? I know weaves are expensive, but when you got that weave that expired 4 months ago and you trying to hold on to that, that is a very bad
How long is weave good for, though?
Depends weave what kind of hair you buy, wig. Right?
It's I don't like look. Wigs. Just the word wig bothers me.
Hey, yo.
But there's some good wigs out there, though.
Everybody they are good wigs. Wig now, believe it
I'm
not.
Trying to find me a good
white
one.
Women.
Just the word wig bothers me. I don't know. Maybe it's me.
Why are they?
I thought you just take it off. And it's
why are you doing that?
What do you
that's
mean?
My thing. Why are you doing that?
Why are you doing what?
I don't do the weave and the wig. Why are you
I do
doing
weave,
that?
Fam.
he got to cover his bases, right? Because everybody got a lady who might have a weave. Yeah. You know what I mean?
But the wig, I just, my grandmother. Weave. Remember back?
Weave is not cool.
No, wig is not like year. That now.
Well, that's how my mind is, though.
Time out.
My mind reminds me of a wig of my grandmother.
You need a period for, like, weave is, like, good 6 months out the year. Not 12 months. Not 365.
I agree with you.
You got to know girls you know where weave was 12 months out the year.
No, there's some out there. I've never seen them.
There's some girls I've never seen their
real hair. Me on the Instagram because I don't want to see them.
I never seen their real hair. I have some chicks I never seen their real hair.
If I don't see their real hair, I don't want to know you.
Their hairline is right here because you know the weave, they
lean
show the
back.
Stitches and
the
shit.
Lean back.
The shit is right here and they don't show their real hair. And I'm not against weave, but I'm saying show me all of you. I should have to live with you to see the real you.
You're right.
What the fuck?
I need to see you not in makeup.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
And I need to see natural. Just some pictures on the gram. Some.
I don't want to put words in your mouth. Are you saying that a physical turnoff is a female who's hiding her appearance?
Because you said you need to see. You too caked up. Like if I got a white shirt and I hug you and your
whole
ass
that is gonna happen when somebody wears makeup.
Oh. No, no. Listen, time out.
Well, I'm sorry.
There's a picture of fucking Little Kim right now.
Ooh, God.
Little Kim face. Though. Her face is Puerto Rican. Her neck is still African. I'm like, yo, that's too much makeup. Chicks gotta stop thinking all that makeup shit is dope. It's not dope.
I think that's deeper than that, though. I think
it's not dope.
Some also with the complexion issues and stuff like that.
But
the
that's listen. Be yourself.
Wait, no.
Be yourself. We live in a day and age where the darkest woman is being wifed up.
But
it's no longer about that anymore.
We don't wear makeup. No. Sometimes we just want to enhance our beauty. You know.
It's not enhancing though. Dudes think it's horrible. Only the females think it's dope.
What?
The dudes think it's horrible.
Yeah, I know.
Nobody like that.
Hold on. It depends on how you put the makeup on, though.
Why would
nobody like
makeup?
A cake.
No. Because I'm not talking about you look good. But sometimes, I don't think y'all put makeup on to go to the gas station.
No.
I know girls that put makeup on just to go to the store. Like,
that's a
it depends on how you put. Like,
and still
no
look
need,
crazy.
Yeah, like, you don't
so
need makeup.
So it's different between looking like you casket ready. Versus how you should be looking when you're walking around in the neighborhood.
I'll be shooting on
you know what I mean? I reiterate points.
But
you know what I'm saying?
But I'm going to tell you. All right, I was waiting. I wanted y'all to get your thoughts out.
I want to tell you something, though. You said we live in an age where even dark-skinned women is getting wiped up.
Yeah.
That sounded crazy.
That sounded crazy.
Yes. I'm actually giving you a chance to rescue yourself.
Because you
and Clara, when you said that, I cringed. I cringed like that.
He said it's a complexion thing.
No, I think
with Little Kim looking
Asian.
But that's no longer an issue. Dark-skinned women are like, they are wanted. It's
they
not
been
like.
Beautiful. What
I didn't say they're not beautiful. Oh,
now you're trying to murder him now. Now you're trying to put him in a bad place.
I'm saying.
I'm trying to help you. He's trying to murder you.
Back in the day, that actually was an issue, right? What I'm saying, right now, people want that.
Lupe Nyong'o, what's her name? You know what I'm talking about, the really dark-skinned African actress who looked really good.
The actress chick, the slim chick, that dude was raping in the fucking movie. I kind of hated that scene.
But
I think it's 12 Years Slave.
Yeah. Exactly.
I ain't like it. But she's beautiful.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm saying. Like,
you saying
skin
out.
Is being, no,
like
I didn't say they just got popping, but it's now,
no,
but it's now,
no,
it's now wanted.
But to support,
it's now wanted more.
To support what Black is saying, though, it's now commercially being accepted.
Exactly.
Right? Because we always knew dark-skinned was beautiful.
Here.
But no. You know, now the world is accepting dark as being
beautiful.
Get
the fuck out of here, man.
Yes.
I don't know about y'all.
Black
I've been accepted. Exactly.
Yeah.
That's okay.
Yeah. So and let me say that as far as pet peeves, you have a lot of these chicks that I noticed something. I want to bring it up, you know, because I need help. You know what I mean?
Yo, put your headphones on.
Listen, DJ Magic, it looks like he's about to fall back. Listen, and just, man. And deal with that. You know what I mean?
This is all a setup. Listen, what I don't notice is that, what I have noticed is that most females that talk this Hossa Diddy shit, this, you know, I make so much money, I drive this, I live here, I go here, I traveled all over the world, they are fucking disgusting. They live disgusting. Disgustingly. I hate slobs, dirty slobs. Your bathroom be dirty, your house be dirty, and you got these high standards. Clean your house first. Clean your house first.
I've been in a situation.
It's a lot of dirty motherfuckers.
To co-sign what you said, I've been in a situation where I'm chilling with a chick and I see her room and the room is messy, and I automatically think her box smells like her room.
Because it does.
And I'm turned off.
The first thing I do is go to a chick. If I go over a chick crib, step one is go to your bathroom. You can fix up anything else.
You
what
never. You looking for?
I'm looking in the tub.
Bathroom is no.
Don't look in the tub. Back. No, you violating privacy. You violating privacy.
Tub, toilet bowl.
You're dirty. Back of the toilet bowl. The side.
Yeah. Tub, toilet bowl. And what do your toothbrush look like? I just want to see it. If your toothbrush ruined, how hard are you brushing,
that
motherfucker?
Is fucking hard as a brick.
That too.
That shit is dry as hell.
That means she using that shit all week long. All week. Same washcloth. No, bitch. Throw that one away.
That was some chick bathroom. I thought she had a cat, yo. I swear to God. Her washcloth smelled like kitty litter, sir.
Oh, see, now you gotta go. Gotta go.
Magic over here looks disgusting right now.
You know, I look.
That's disgusting.
I'm so picky with certain things, and that bathroom situation
is serious
to me.
It's serious. Before you check the bed sheets, when I go to a hotel, you gotta check the bed sheets.
Yeah.
Let me see if y'all gave me some fresh sheets.
Yeah.
You go to a chick crib,
okay, no,
bathroom. Let me see. Let me see your shoes.
And you know what's the crazy thing about it is? My wife always says she not having company until all the bathrooms are clean. And I was just like, why? She said, people are nosy. People look in your bathtub.
Yo, and you got a nice eye. Marv got a nice bathroom. You know what I mean?
Thank you.
We did the first show with his crib. His
that.
Shit was fucking phenomenal. I
ain't
gonna lie. I wish I had a number two with me when I was there, but I only had to do a number one. But there's a nice bathroom. You can chill in there. You can meditate. It's some meditation.
I appreciate
type
that.
It means
that.
A lot. It
showed
a lot about your character.
His bathroom was nice.
Yeah.
I gave him a different handshake after I seen the bathroom. I said, shit, that should
be.
You know what I
mean? You know, he showed me more love after that. I do remember that. I do remember that.
But a lot of people, and La just said that he don't care about the bed sheets.
That's disgusting.
That's disgusting because let me tell you something.
Listen,
no, let me tell you something. A lot of people don't change their
sheets.
Hit
him with the big pun.
Yes.
A lot of people sleep on the same sheets 2 weeks. 2 weeks, most of these motherfuckers is hoes. Most of these motherfuckers is side hoes and side bitches and side niggas. So you talking about three or four motherfuckers sleeping on them sheets within them 2 weeks.
Yeah.
Three or four different
people.
Dirty motherfuckers. The motherfucker with the nails, the motherfucker with the dirty ears, the motherfucker with all the buggers that she say, he's trapping. All of them slept on that bed. Now,
dude,
I need some fresh
got a drooling
issue.
Why
are you in the crib with that person if you know that's what they
do? You know what I'm saying?
That's my part.
You might not know that until you get...
No, you have to know, bro.
You know.
Who's bringing over five of the dudes that was in the club. You know that.
Yeah.
So if I know she's bringing five dudes in the club, I don't even want to be around this type of person.
Facts.
I respect that.
That could be like a pet peeve, though.
But you know what? You guys are going into the second portion of this topic, right? Which is the sexual turn-offs as far as pet peeves, right? So because now y'all starting talking about, you know, dealing with the chick who might smash four or five dudes, no bed sheet change, you know what I'm saying? So what's the sexual turn-offs, pet peeves for you guys?
Ladies first.
What's the sexual turn-off?
Yeah. Because we described the physical first.
I guess you in the zone, get ready to go, and he do something like,
mood killers. Mood killers, things that make you go from rainforest to Sahara Desert, you know, things like that.
I don't like to be, this may sound crazy, a lot of females probably don't agree with me. I don't like to be asked, like, do you want me to do this? Or you want me to do this?
So you want him to grab that head, grab your palm, your head, and go and force it down.
I just like to go with the flow. Like, don't ask me no questions. Like, if you feel like it's the right time to do it, then just do it.
So he mess around and throw a thumb in your ass. It's all good. Okay, you see, that's what communication's the key.
A thumb in your ass is good, though. That's not bad for you.
Oh, that's all about your character.
Yeah.
I was waiting for you to slip.
It's not.
Talk that shit.
You like a thumb in your
it's
ass.
It's not bad.
You just don't like a chubby thumb. You don't want the wide thumb. You want like a regular thumb. Like
so
this is a regular
one. You just
want to
do it on your own. You don't really care. Don't want anybody to ask you to do it.
Don't ask me. Just do it.
So you do it all then?
Do what?
So you do it. So you do it all. You just do it all. So you don't want nobody asking.
She basically do it.
Shout out to Star with that.
If I don't like it, then I brush it off. Like, you know, don't do that or like move it on. But don't ask me. I just don't like that.
Okay.
I like you to go with the flow. Like, if you feel like it's the right time to do it, then do it.
So dude, just say, you know what? I'm just gonna go straight anal on her. I ain't gonna ask. I'm just gonna.
Her face is like, what?
That's why we gotta have communication. Let me tell you.
Communication before you start this project.
If you're having sex and you know what I like, you know through conversation. From the date.
But that's my thing, though.
I'm pretty sure some of y'all dudes met with girls and y'all done had sexual intercourse and y'all done bust all over their faces and shit like that. Like, you know who y'all doing that shit to.
Forgiveness, not permission.
this dude lied is crazy.
I'm going to use that one.
A motherfucker's supposed to bust on your face.
The bust on the face is mandatory, is what it means to say.
You're right. There's nothing wrong with that.
I'm never telling a chick when I'm coming. Especially German head, I'm never saying nothing. You got to be crazy.
You
got to
be crazy.
I ain't telling nobody.
You
got to
be crazy.
License is 9/11. He don't tell.
What you doing?
No show, no tell.
My cooties ain't back like me. Stroking my dick until I come.
Oh, yes. Leave this in your mouth.
Y'all dudes is wild, man. Oh,
then she start coughing.
You're about to give me trouble. Like, I don't know what y'all talking about.
Listen, let Magic discuss his turn off.
I don't know what y'all talking about. I am good.
Your sexual turn off.
Listen. You speak good.
I'm a good guy, and you know, I'm just, about to have a baby, so.
We understand, but you know, we all in situations, so a lot of times we kind of go back into our single days or a situation that had happened.
Back in the day.
We know statute of limitations are crazy, so we always protect ourselves.
Damn, man, I'm a. This is a hard question because I'm really into like going all in. I ain't gonna hold you up.
There ain't something that a chick could do with just like, especially made my dick so.
But Damn. I don't know. I'm stuck on this.
If I could throw one out for me, is teeth during oral. When there's too much teeth, I'd be wanting to punch you right in your face like. But I don't do that. I don't do that. I don't punch people in the face.
That never happened. I don't know. I'm
you never caught teeth?
Nah.
You lucky. You blessed. You blessed.
I put up through a process, bro.
You blessed.
He said, I put up through a process. Had his popsicle real quick, shorty. All
right. I'm going to tell you what my problem. I'm going to tell you what my number one thing is. And it happened before. And I put a girl through a process. If your pussy stink.
I can't continue.
All right. Listen to me, bro.
Okay.
You know what? If your pussy stink, all right. Number one, don't get mad. I'm gonna tell you that your pussy stink.
Yeah.
All right. As you should.
Mm-hmm. All right. And then it needs to be something further than just me telling you. Like it's a problem.
This action should follow this.
Why is yours and then hers? Like what are you doing? And
you send it to the shower.
A shower's not.
It's not a shower.
It's not a shower, bro.
That's germs and bacteria. That's many niggas nutting in you. That's you just being dirty.
No.
You not taking care of yourself.
Let the woman
speak on it. That way we get a better understanding.
We had a little seminar about this one time, and the guy said the same thing. But he told her, and he let her clean off, and he proceed to do whatever they were supposed to do. Now.
But she just came from a track meet or some shit?
No, she actually had a body odor or something she just couldn't get rid of. That was her.
Did that
ever happen to you? Did you ever speak to like your GYN about this kind of stuff?
I fucking vegetables, B.
Did you ever go to your GYN and say, hey, my pussy is, you know, is kind of off?
I never really had that problem.
Every chick can't be safe, so I'm saying.
No, I'm dead ass. I never had that problem. Never asked.
You good. So you don't have no funny
rumors.
And just because you spraying.
You got flies flying around.
And just because you spraying down, it don't mean that that's going to fix the shit.
That's masking. That's masking.
Another thing, since you got me started, another thing I don't like too.
We got Magic amped up.
Just starting to kick in.
Right? Then I get it.
after we have sex, all right, don't give me baby wipes, fam.
That make you feel like you was with an escort, like, or something.
Why are we talking about a baby?
I'm not giving you a baby wipe, but I'm gonna probably bring you a washcloth.
Not a baby wipe. I don't want them popping and then. What's the difference of a baby wipe?
No, I'm curious to know. Like, why don't you like a baby wipe?
Maybe you're not good enough for a washcloth, fam.
You don't have a bathroom to give me a wash rag.
Fair, maybe she just wants you out. Maybe it's time for you to go. Here's this wet wipe and a bottle of water.
Where is your bathroom?
I'm
gonna
pass me a sock off the floor, man.
I'm like
this, man.
Nah, I'm a fancy nigga.
Magic said I'm a fancy nigga.
I want the bathroom, which should have been neat. It shouldn't have been in no hard rags in that bitch anyway. You know what I'm saying? Go back to that. I want hot water. I don't want my. Hot water steam makes us. You know what I mean?
Yeah, everybody that got wiped over with a dirty sock or a t-shirt. Stop lying, man.
That's in the car. Son.
No,
he said that's in the car.
Whatever you just took off, man.
In the house?
Magic, you know you better than me. Cause I thought the wet wipe was standard or cool.
Nah, I
got handed the wet wipe.
This is what strippers use.
Since when this became popping?
That's what strippers and prostitutions use.
She could have gave you the tissue that leaves residue.
You go to the bathroom. Yo, even the hotel, you go to the bathroom. Even the hotel, you go to the bathroom. Only time I'm taking a wet wipe is if I'm in my car, bro.
What's that? What the fuck is that movie? The Brooklyn movie with the cops and they fucking taking the motherfucking money and shit. The bitch was in the bathroom with the wet wipe. The fucking hooker that the cop kept
on fucking. Wet wipes is not. That's for babies.
Was it Brooklyn Finest?
Brooklyn Finest.
Yes, I remember that.
The hooker was in the bathroom wiping up with the wet wipes.
Was it Richard Gere the cop who wanted to wifey the hooker?
Yeah, he wiped
after he seen the other cops leave?
She was in the bathroom with the wet wipes like this. Oh, I'm sorry you had to see
these
that,
chicks,
baby.
These chicks ain't got time to take a shower.
And then she took the Victoria's Secret and sprayed.
Victoria's Secret doesn't save your life, bitch.
It's Max. It's a Febreze effect. Chicks be Febreze in the poo poo.
That's not good. That's not good.
That's not good.
Yeah, but went in there like, that's just some whole
thing. Shout out to Star with the choker. It looked like you missing that little red ball for that freakiness from your choker.
Oh, God.
This nigga,
Marv. Marv,
that don't look like that, though?
The what? Say it again.
Nah.
50 Shades of Grey, he got that room.
I just observed the choker.
Wait, you know what?
I just observed the choker with the little red ball. All right, we'll move on.
Y'all know the choker with the red ball? That's some freaky shit, son. Get your freak out, son. I watch a little bit more porno, man, for real.
Yeah.
I'm like chicks that try to have sex with the light off. That shit's
turned up. Yeah, that's an insecure shit. That's some insecure. Oh, a bitch, I leave her shirt on. I know your stomach fucked up already. Just take that shit off, man. We fucking.
No. I need to see. Y'all.
wait.
She be keeping her shirt on like this. Trying to hide all the after birth shit. Nah, let that shit rock, man. Let that shit rock.
Stretch marks.
Show me the eye of the tiger.
Fuck it.
A war wounds, man. Ain't nothing wrong with stretch marks.
And I'll tell you the truth. You gotta turn the light on, cause it'd be a lot of funny shit happening. It'd be kind of pimples. It'd be pimples around the pussy. It'd be different kind of polka dots. What's going on here, bitch? It'd be some worms. You know, some bitches got different kind of discharges.
Yo, Black just hit off a homeless chick. Once he said he saw worms, that's homeless punani. Black has hit homeless punani. That's homeless punani. Once you said you seen worms. That's homeless punani, son.
No, that's shelter poo poo.
No, I don't know. Don't even continue this shit.
That's a scary movie, bro.
I was with him
when he said bumps, right? Because sometimes bumps is not because of STD. Bumps is because she shaved, raised the bump. But once you said worms, I can't justify the worm comment, bitch.
Yo, hold on. I'll call you back. This dumb nigga Jerry so fucking... I call you back, my nigga.
Yo, that shit is crazy, son. That shit is crazy. Stay away. I can't do it, man. That's like yeast infection to the seventh power.
That's some weird joint.
Worms is like a joke, but you know what I'm talking about.
Females have different.
Every female don't have the same situation down there.
Yeah, we get that. What's worms? Yeah.
Wingworms.
No, maggots.
Maggots.
You can't fuck wingworms.
This is some crazy.
Oh my God.
All right, we're gonna move on. I'm gonna go to the wild card segment. And my wild card question Magic, if you don't know, is this a question I come up with off the top? I don't let these guys get no prep for it and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Today, we're going to keep it light. My wild card question is, what is the worst curve situation you ever been in? As far as, you know, trying to holler at someone, like, what's the worst curve situation you ever had? I'm going to give mine real quick because it's short and sweet. Mm-hmm. In college, I was chilling, studying with a girl and my roommate, you know, vibing, laughing, joking, funny dude and stuff like that. Vibe's cool. I was single, shoulders single. My man was like, yo, why don't you give him a shot? You single, he's single, y'all smart, y'all hanging off and stuff like that. Shorty straight looked at me and said, how can I date a dude with bigger titties than I have? That was the most savage. I was just like, mine ain't lying, but she had to say that. You know what
did
I'm saying?
Did you slap her?
Nah, it was savage. It was savage. But you know what? That's my people's now, right?
Domestic she violence just, gotta live.
She doesn't have no filter, right? Mm-hmm. So she just, that was the first thing she thought, and that's what she said. And I just shook her hand, and I just bounced. You know what I'm saying? What was my reply to that? You know what I'm saying? So that's the most savage curve I've ever got.
Wow.
I need examples of the most savage curve you ever had. Don't give me, everybody gets shot down. You know what I'm saying? You shoot your shot, you get knocked down. I don't care who you are. I don't care how fly you are. You know what I'm saying? If someone said they never got shot down, they've never sent out a lot of requests. You never holler at a lot of people. You know what I'm saying? It comes with numbers. So I want a lady. Because ladies act like they don't holler at dudes, so you gotta have a curve story.
2016.
You know what I'm saying? That's not even that funny.
What's the most savage curve you ever received?
And don't be lying. Tell us the
truth.
I'm
gonna be honest. It happened recent. It happened this year, 2016, for the first time. And
happened
I was like,
this year?
Yeah.
Damn, the first time you ever got shot down?
Yeah.
You kind of fuck out of here. Your first time
I'm dead ass.
Out.
I swear to God.
You ain't that cute, motherfucker.
Tell me about it, because I was devastated. I was like, wait, did he just... I don't want to talk about it. I'm still stuck on it.
What is that? Tell us.
That's what this show's about. You know what I'm saying? We show humility. Ain't no egos.
All right, let me think.
Just don't use my name. I mean, just use a different name.
Don't use my name.
It's not even that funny,
guys. Well, you know, first of all, tell us, why were you trying to holler at him?
No, time out. I wasn't trying to holler at the person. Me and the person was already talking.
Uh-huh.
And while we were talking, he basically was like, you know, this is the first time. Like, this is the first time this ever happened to me. He was like, you know, we don't have no titles, boo. Like,
You try to act like a girlfriend. He put you in your place.
I wasn't even trying to act like a girlfriend. I was just saying I don't like something. Like, don't do this. I don't like it.
He like, man, you don't,
he's
like, you don't
to
hold
you know
that weight.
He's a free man. Who the fuck you talking to?
Yeah, basically. And I was like, oh shit.
Put you in your place.
Wow.
That's why. Oh no, he didn't.
You got to step your box up. Cause good pussy, a nigga would have listened. He'd be like, you know what, bro?
He said, step my box up.
You got to step it up. You got to do something. Dude, you got to do box exercise or something like that.
Kegels and all that stuff like that.
I'm going to just sip to that one.
Know how to flex the muscles. Get your Hulk Hogan on. Flex, squeeze, flex, squeeze.
I was devastated. I was like, wait, technically we ain't together, but nobody ain't ever tell me no shit like that.
Lie, what about you? What was the worst curve you ever got?
I don't know, kid. I can't.
Handsome lies.
Get the fuck. You was fat back in the day, and you got the big ass ears, nigga. Get the fuck.
Yeah,
you got curved,
you was fat
nigga.
Back in the day.
You got curved, Dumbo. Stop fucking lying out here.
I heard you was
fuck
fat.
Out of here.
You need to give your story, nigga. Oh, you got a lot of them. That's why you fucking bullshit. Hey, yo.
Black is next. Black is next. I just want you to.
Yeah,
let us off real quick.
I should be lax, man.
I want to hear.
I don't have stories like that because I never really shoot my shot unless I know I got my foot in the door. Ready to go. It's very,
you know,
rare.
I lost a lot of situations being safe, but you know, before I got savaged out,
I had to throw my shot out there. I ain't gonna say I never lost by being safe, because you know, like, he who hesitates masturbates. That's how I go.
Yo, that is the real talk quote of the day. He who hesitates masturbates. That's real talk.
That's some truth to that.
But I never, like, unless she give me the eye or something, yeah. I'm like, I can know, like, I can get that.
Yeah.
I ain't gonna really shoot my shot. It's like, I guess it's like a fear of
damn,
rejection.
Damn, like, I have
thing.
To interrupt. You just described my whole life. He who hesitate masturbates.
Listen, bro, I got a whole damn. Bunch of one-liners, man. Philosophy. Yeah, rapper? Yeah, here you go.
Rapper?
D-Ray dropped the beat.
Chicka. All right, what about you, Black? What about you?
The craziest one, I got shut down. Yo, man, back in the day, I was an ugly motherfucker.
Listen, you was ugly yesterday.
What the fuck are you talking about? Nigga, tell
Lash at you. You ugly right now. You ugly right now.
Go ahead, Black.
Go ahead. My man Black said, I'm glowed up.
You're crazy.
Yo, Black is a fake T.
Be real, nigga. Yo, that's ain't my nigga.
Fuck your fucking nigga. Yo, back in the day, I was ugly, son. Yeah. I'm okay with it, you feel me?
Back in the hours, I was fucked up, man.
I ain't that bad no more, son. Yeah, I was skinny with a big head, but you know what I mean? Yeah. But I always had good outfits, my nigga. Always had good
outfits. Yo, that's Black's go-to. Black go-to is I always had good outfits, yo.
I always had good outfits, and I had a great GPA. For those that don't know, I was a 4.3 my whole life. But back to the conversation. So, one day...
Yo, what's in this cup?
I don't know. One day in motherfucking shout out to Brown Holy Water Podcast. Make sure you share this video. Share this video.
Yeah,
all right?
At Brown Holy Water.
Shout out to my
Twitter.
Man DJ Magic Hot 97. Instagram. We in the building. Here we go. So
oh my god.
So one day in college, man, I seen this chick, son, and she was bad. I got this thing for chicks with like dreads and shit. I love dreads and shit.
I like that movement.
So this chick had dreads and shit, and I was like, oh shit. Then she got the onion. She had it was just going for her. She had everything flowing.
Yeah.
So boom, I could, you know, it's a little basketball game. I scoop over there. I'm like, yo, what's up, girl? She's like, hey, what's up? What's your name? She give me her name, whatever. We parlaying, we talking and shit. So she was like, all right, gave me a little play. Then she kept it pushing, like she went to the bathroom and shit. I'm like, boom, I hope she come back to the seat. She came back to the seat and she was like, yo, you hooked me up with your friend?
Oh wow.
And like all my shit was letting her know I'm interested. Like all my shit was like, yeah, what's up? Like, where you from?
We already talked about I live in the friend zone.
I walked into the friend zone.
Damn.
Yeah,
you definitely did.
I walked right into the motherfucker. And she told me, hook me. Like I was a girl. I don't like when chicks do that. Like,
I got hit with that a couple of times.
Whenever chicks try to homegirl me, I get them the fuck out of here. Like, I'm not your homegirl. You're not gonna.
That's a mush moment. You know what I'm saying? If ever a woman's eligible to get mush, she's eligible to get mush during that kind of situation.
Now I was tight. I just left. I just looked at
that's
her on some like.
You should have hooked up.
Nah, I had to get the fuck out of there, geez.
If somebody on the team hit, that means we all successful.
Yeah. Nah, get the fuck out of here.
If I want her, but she wants you, I'm gonna put you on so you can hit. See, you're a hater. You a hater.
I done passed a lot of assists.
No. He's not gonna do this shit, my nigga. He's playing.
I know him.
He's not gonna fuck you up, my nigga. Yo, bro, I want her back. He's not gonna connect that dot, my nigga.
He's
like, nah, I'm still gonna get this one.
Listen, son, I liked her, bro. I was
know.
Nah, son, get the fuck out of here. I hated that shit. That shit had me tight, son. That shit hurt my feelings, son. I had a good outfit on that day, too.
My man had a good outfit on.
Yo, that means outfit on.
They said that's what the ugly people had to do. They had to dress, you know.
Yo, we got to.
I'm not saying he's
not, but you can't have you can't have mutual struggles.
I'm okay with it. I was ugly.
He slipped out.
You can't have mutual struggles. You can't be ugly and stink, ugly and dress whack.
Saying.
You know what I'm saying? You gotta.
That's
you know,
what I'm saying.
Like, as a fat dude, I can't be stink.
Yeah.
I can't be dressed crazy. I gotta have some kind of swag.
Facts.
That's true.
And a couple of hours.
And a couple of dollars.
And a couple of dollars.
And some shiny things too. Shout out to Black with the new chain. You know what I mean? Life's been good for Black. I gotta promote my man. Even though he does his own promotion, I gotta promote my man.
Nobody better than you.
Yeah.
New Year's Eve, meet me at Club Lussie.
I knew he was gonna say that.
4.3 GPA. Yes.
Let Magic talk. Magic, what was the worst curve you ever had?
Damn, man. I'm gonna keep it funky with y'all, man. That's how I am. I DJ all over the place and this the cash, there's all that blah blah blah. But I'm really a shy dude, man. Like I don't really go
too,
up.
Man. Oh my god, y'all kill me.
Have you ever used your status like, you know?
Never did.
To chip like yeah,
never did.
Yo, shorty, you know I DJ on Hot 97. You never say
He'll say, I know Magic, my 97.
I use Magic all the time.
I run his car show.
Google
Magic. I'm his manager, whatever. He would do it.
I got back when I was single. That car show got me so much punani.
Yeah, I heard, motherfucker.
Like it's in my hood. It's in Coney Island. I live up the block. It's in my hood.
Yeah.
Like you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And Magic just let me run the whole stage. I said, "This nigga crazy. You gotta give me the mic. Oh, this nigga crazy.
I'm really,
yeah, you already know who it is, DJ Magic." And it's lit. The bitches be like, yo, how do I get up there? You gotta fuck me.
He's dead serious too.
Like, oh yo, my whole team, man. My whole team is like,
that's why he had that wormy coochie.
I'm really
he caught a shorty at the shelter, like, yo.
Turn the lights on, though. Turn the lights on.
No, but let Magic finish. I'm sorry. Let Magic finish. Let Magic finish.
I mean, like, I'm not really I would rarely approach. I mean, what he said earlier about the masturbating shit, he pretty much right about that.
Yeah, they who do.
I'm not going masturbate.
He who hesitate.
You know what I'm saying?
Masturbate.
But I'll be home like, damn, my nigga. You know what I'm saying?
I should have shot my shot.
Yeah, you know what I mean? So then Instagram came out, and then made things a little more, you know, a little more easier.
Slide
but
DMs.
Yeah, but I'm not really like a, you know, I did get turned down before.
What does it mean? Like, I want to hear a mean story.
It was for I'll never forget this shit because it's funny now to me. I was out with a friend of mine and I was always into like females that was doing something.
Yeah.
Once I know a female doing something, like she getting money, she got her shit together, she got her insurance, she got, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I always wanted that, but I'm not the person.
She ain't have no worms.
She had no worms. Nothing coming out looking, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I told my man, I was heavy on yo, my nigga, hook me up with shorty, you know what I'm saying? Cause you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, and then he went over there, did his thing, and blah blah blah. He's like, yo, you know, this dude wanna holler at you and stuff like that. I never want nobody to know what I do. I just want them to know I'm just a regular person, right?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So then, you know, he went over and then we started talking. Me and the girl started talking. And all of a sudden she was like, yo, so what are you driving? So I'm like, I'm a car guy now. I wish.
I just hate that question though.
You know what I'm saying? But at the time, I didn't have a car.
Yeah.
So, you know, I'm like, nah, I don't got a car right now. You know what I'm saying?
I got
a
mean unlimited metro car.
To get my money up.
Yeah.
And instantly off of that, it was like, okay, now nice to meet you. You know what I'm saying? And that really hurt.
Wow.
My whole.
You might have saved yourself though. Because
probably
if that was
did.
A mentality,
yeah.
if that yes. was a question,
yes.
to me, I feel disgusted. Like,
yes.
I told a story earlier, not to cut you off, that I went on a first date, and then Shorty said, oh, so when we going on a trip? And this is our first date.
Yeah.
It kind of made me feel like, ugh.
Yeah. Now, I mean, now, you know, if you think about that, like, bitch, I wish a bitch asked me,
I got a spaceship outside. I'm a damn astronaut. I'm a damn astronaut right now.
Now versus then, if a girl asks you that now, you're going to still get her place?
Good question.
Exactly. No, you're not.
The magic I am now, and this nigga could vouch for it, I'm the worst. You don't. I'm not trying to hear nothing.
Yeah, he ain't with it. He ain't.
I'm not trying to hear nothing. Because you got to, anything you ask me for, I don't ask you for nothing. I need you to have your own. And I'm willing to help out the situation.
Yeah.
But don't ask me for, you know what I mean? But before, that was the whole.
All right. So we're going to move on to the next topic. And the next topic kind of touched on something you said earlier, because you said you're about to be a dad.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So congratulations to you on that.
Thank you.
Our next topic is that's just my baby mama, baby daddy, right? So, like, why aren't people more selective with who they choose to procreate with? A lot of people, it's funny, there was a meme out there, right? Your first baby mama, they show 50 in his first baby mama, and they show 50 with his second baby mama. Like, not to diss his first baby mama, but she don't look nothing like the second baby mama, right? But 50 done glowed up, so we know that.
Right.
But I'm saying, so why aren't people more selective on who they choose to be a baby mother with, right? I'm not a father, so I can't really speak on it, but you and La could have a conversation on that. So you don't have no children?
Mm-hmm.
You have a child?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so Star can speak on that
mama?
As well.
Don't call me that. Do not call me nobody's baby
mother. A child's mother. You know what I'm saying? Anyway, that's
ladies first. You always get to speak on it first.
Wait, what is the question?
So, why aren't people more selective with who they choose to procreate with?
I mean, I can only speak for myself. I feel like I was very selective, but I was selective. And, you know, people change after time. I was young when I first had my child. My child is 7. I'm 30. I had one when I was 22, 23.
Yeah.
That's good age, though.
That's not a good age.
Wow, you look mad young, so shout out to you. Good genes.
You do.
Good genes.
I know
you
do.
Yeah, but you
I
old,
thought
you
was like 23, 24 now.
Nah, fuck it.
I can't stand his ass. But yeah, I feel like at that time and point, I was selective.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was young. Now I'm 30. We change. We grow different ways. Like, we're not into the same thing anymore.
I think that's if I could just speak, you know.
Not I don't even from experts on.
I just feel like, you know, sometimes dudes are running around smashing whatever they can smash, and then sometimes something happens, and now you got,
you know, a baby mother that you ain't really choose to select. You know,
see, my thing is different because let me tell you something. There's dudes like that smash or whatever the case, maybe an accident happens. But then there's also dudes that be like, yo, like, no, keep the baby. We could do this, we could do that. There's guys that put pressure on women, too, just the same way.
Nah, facts.
Just
facts,
the same
facts,
way
facts,
that
facts.
Females put pressure on dudes. Yeah. Facts. So it's, yeah, same thing.
Facts. Magic.
But I don't think people not as selective because everybody, like, chooses their mates by, like, the physical.
Yeah. You don't look sure at got a fatty
physical or his car or his job title or his salary.
Facts.
You fucking the wrong shit, but
a chick want to give you a baby.
True.
A chick want to give you a baby.
That is true. That is true. That is true.
No, let me tell you something. There are dudes that go to church every Sunday. They have Christian backgrounds. Uh-huh. They have morals. They have values. But those are the ones that you really have to watch out for. The ones that be in church all the time.
Those are the ones
that got like 5 kids over here.
No, but there's a lot of people. Hold on. Time out. Let's not ignore the fact. There's a lot of ignorant people that want to have a child with somebody because they feel like they're going to have a cute baby. Or they feel like they're going to have a dope baby. Yeah. Or most of the time when you ask chicks about their dude, they don't describe no characteristics. They say he's a firefighter. He makes 6 figures. He drives a duh. So you're describing materialistic things. So then when he ended up being a bullshit baby father, and you say, oh, black men are not shit or all dudes are not shit. These are your choices. These are your choices on what you're going for. You understand?
Somebody said, "Shout out Rob Kardashian." See?
Oh no! Wow.
but look, and look, you gotta watch out for all chicks that's watching Black China. Why you following her?
On top of this though, we actually don't know what's going on with Nate behind closed doors, because that guy could be insane.
No,
she's
stop
probably
that.
Running
stop
away
that.
From
stop
y'all
that.
Y'all understand?
Stop
some
that.
Of y'all dudes.
This
are
this is what getting pregnant by dudes that got money is a fucking business. Let's not front.
Before we go off tangent. Before we get off topic, I want to hear Magic
this
on
is,
the topic.
This is really one of the main things that's happening nowadays with this. Social media is one of the main things I feel that is causing a lot of this shit that's going on. Because people sit there and look at everything and get assumptions of, you know, how big this person is and where I want to be in life and likes and this. Mm-hmm. And then they're looking at other females or other people's situations
and comparing
into a situation just because. They really don't want to be in it,
right.
But sometimes social media makes you rush.
Mm-hmm.
Then you might be at a certain age, and then people don't even care no more after a while. They're like, you know what, I'm just going to do that. And they selling for whoever they knew I knew this person for this amount of time.
And if they don't come through, I'm going to just raise the kid on my own kind of thing.
I'm going to raise them on my own. You know what I mean? People already planned.
They're already talking about that before the baby born.
They're already planned on not, they're not going to be there. This is because I have to do this, or because I want to do this, or because I'm not doing nothing. And social media makes you feel like your life is shit in a day. You could have went to Miami, had a time with your life, family, everything. Mm-hmm. You read the most, everything. And then tomorrow, somebody else puts something up, and then you're like, damn, my life is bullshit. My nigga, you just fucking did a whole situation. Yeah. Now you're thinking that your life is
trash. Because we keep up with the Joneses with the social media. Because
everyone's trying to compare.
Everybody's trying to compare.
Stop trying to compare.
So that's really one of the main things, bro, is everybody just selling because of what they're looking at on. And I'm talking about grown folks. This is
adults.
Not only.
Adults.
This is not that's kids.
And yo, you know what's crazy? I seen that episode where you was telling me like how that chick was doing everything for likes and. On the show,
Insecure? The Black Mirror. Oh, Black Mirror on fucking Netflix.
Season 3, episode 1.
The chick was doing everything for likes. Like, they could send you likes right then and there. Like, they could rate you 5-star, 3-star. As soon as you meet the person. So she was like acting all like, just to like get a couple
just
like, hey, how are you? You look so nice today. I hope the sun shine on you. Give her two.
I'm serious, man.
What he just described just now with the Miami shit one day, then I might post Dubai. And
I was
now all of
Dubai.
A sudden you just, oh my God, my life. That's how people, swear to God.
And that's been a day's time I've seen people do it.
This week, I changed my life. I jumped the broom. I got engaged.
Yeah.
And I'ma just say this. You would never know. You would never know how many people was really like. I know I got a lot of likes. A few of them was genuine.
Yeah.
But some of them was
nosy.
But
you got hate too though.
Oh, it's a lot of hate.
Yeah.
It's a lot of hate because now people feel like now they're comparing what I'm doing to their relationship. I don't know what you and your man going through.
Right. But now imagine you at a certain status and you cool with people and you do something like that. How many people do you think is gonna now see your situation and now say I want to do the same thing?
No, listen. I just told.
But now, do you think that's genuine though?
It's not. Like I lie.
We all live that race where we're trying to keep up with
someone
people.
Someone called me yesterday. I swear, this girl never gave me pussy. Never.
She upset.
Never. And she's not the only one, but she literally called me to let it out too. A lot of people inbox me and text. She called me like, yo, what the fuck? Like, I was okay with you having a girlfriend, but now you engaged. Like, what the fuck? Mm-hmm. And I'm like, yo, you joking, right? I'm trying to park to go see R. Kelly. I'm like, you joking, right?
No.
She was dead ass.
Serious.
Yeah. Dead
I go
ass.
That, I go through that because
now
the time.
Her dude going through something and whatever. They've been talking longer and he, you know, there's no.
I told y'all before, I've had chicks who was just like, oh man, you married now? Oh, I was just thinking about you. No, you weren't.
No, you wasn't. No.
Tell us
you
something.
Just, my fault. You just. You,
I ain't get a call, a text, or nothing.
Listen, this the real shit. A lot. It's a difference between renting and getting a mortgage. Mm-hmm. That mortgage is every month. I don't give a fuck what happened. Who died in your family? Who got shot? Don't give a fuck. That mortgage is guaranteed. Rent, you can up and leave. You can not pay, go to court. You can do mad shit.
Yeah.
Nobody. Mortgage means someone is trying to keep you.
Yeah.
So too much people being rented. So when you get engaged.
There's too many people that's rathering being rented, though.
Yeah. Yeah, but don't get it twisted.
How many people are cool with being the side bitch?
A female that tell me she don't want to be married is a liar. I'm scared of you.
She just don't want.
I'm scared of you.
Once you tell yourself that I don't want that,
every female
cool,
want to be fucking married.
You release some of the stress. You release some of the stress expectations.
I'm not gonna lie. I want to be married, but there are some females that have been put through so much, like being dating wise, they don't want to.
Nine out of ten females.
9.5 out of 10.
Yes. Want to be fucking married. What the fuck are we talking about?
No, so now, there are some listen, people that's
listen,
actually scared of
no, no, listen. If you change your mind because you got hurt, that's something else.
Yeah.
You understand? But you originally wanted to be married. So when they see somebody else is getting, I had somebody unfriend me because my girl is not black. She's like, is this black love?
Yeah.
Does it matter, bitch?
I told you I'm married to a Spanish woman.
I'm disappointing you. This is different.
Don't do that, because people gonna take that serious, lie.
I can love who I want.
Exactly.
I love who I want.
But you know,
because I tell you the truth, these black chicks, the bad ones, they didn't want to give me the time of day. They didn't want to give me the time of day. They might.
That's fair. That's fair. No, no, we gonna have that. That's gonna be another show. That's another show.
Listen, these black chicks, most of them, they entertained me a little bit of conversation. Some gave me some coochie. But when it came to going to the next level and being serious, the demand was too. They wanted me. They demanded so much. No, they demanded more than what they even came with. And it wasn't partnership. The reason why my shorty got the ring. And I just told it to Magic.
Because him and I talk a lot about this stuff, and he's saying what I'm about to say.
I went to Canada last week, right? Yeah. I missed my plane.
Yeah.
The first plane I was supposed to get, I missed it, and I'm gonna tell you why. I sent my shorty a picture of it's like a ring with 3 carrots on it. Literally the fucking vegetable, 3 carrots.
Yeah. Yeah,
right?
I seen that ring.
A joke, right. I sent it to her. This is her reply. She said, LOL. Women today are too needy. All I need is love. Mm. I said, yo, let me go get this girl her ring now. Yeah. And that's how I missed my plane. I went to buy the engagement ring. I wanted to be in my house for when I return I could just ask her. You know what I mean? Yeah. I was like, yo, this chick, the way she think, the way she move is just different. Mm. Now, this is not an ethnicity thing. She was just raised different. She got different morals, different standards. It's more just a team thing with her. Mm. And that's when I was looking for a partner instead of just a relationship. Some people are just trying to date to say they have somebody, but they ain't trying to build.
Which, I want you to say your point well, Magic, but this leads me to the second portion. Mm-hmm. No, of the same topic. What are the good qualities to look for in a person before you choose to go to that level of creating a child with them?
Okay, so... what I believe in, and because I've been through a lot, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And Black brought me up here because, you know, I could talk. I take certain things real serious. And actually, you know, we joke around and stuff like that, you know. But I've been through a lot. And before you get into certain, everybody has a guideline of like, okay, so we're going to get married first, in the house, then the kid, and stuff mm-hmm. like that. Nah, this is 2016, bro. They didn't have Instagram and Snapchat back then. Things changed a little bit, yeah. All right? So you have to actually know a person physically. Mm-hmm. This goes back to the makeup situation. Like, you might meet a girl in a club, and you might know her for 3 months, but she might have wore makeup for 3 months, too. Mm-hmm. You might not have never seen her without the makeup. Mm-hmm. When she take a shit, she might make noises. You know what I'm saying? Oh, little things like that. No, seriously. You have to actually know these things before you actually have to bring somebody else in this world, which is going to now make you together forever, even if you're not together.
Yeah.
And you know what I'm saying? You got to move in to see if you can actually deal with this person. Mm-hmm. So certain things have to slow down. You might have to take your time, get to know them off the air. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Don't meet them if you in a scene. Like, mm-hmm. I don't want people liking you, 'cause that's never going to last. You know what I'm saying? If I just met you and people like you and liking and stuff like that, it's never going to last. You have to physically know them off of social medias and other people.
You need
people
to know the
business.
Real them.
I need to know the real you. Mm-hmm. I don't want people, I don't want other opinions about you without me picking my own opinion. I'm an adult. You know what I'm saying? Then actually, you can actually gradually, you know what I'm saying, had the house and things like that. You know what I mean? Before I had a kid with the person I'm with now, I didn't even bring her to my crib until a year after I knew her.
Wow, that's a long time.
Yeah, she might a year. She didn't know where
my
I lived.
My wife lived with me after
for
6 months.
For a year.
This, you know this what I'm saying? Facts.
Reason is because, real quick, reason is because once she knows where you live and she doesn't like you, she might hate you so much that she could set you up.
Yeah, that's
true. Yeah.
And you can't live in peace.
Right.
I got three cars, my nigga. I got three cars, a nice house. You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to bring her into my crib, and now I gotta move my ass out of there because Jerome, that she might want to fuck with, might come to my crib. You know what I'm saying?
Like the money and violence situation, how Rafe and Miz used to get the bad chicks.
Yo, this shit
up.
Happens. This is not a movie. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Let somebody know you live at, and then they come to find out. Oh, she don't like you. Mm-hmm. Or she might not even have intentions like you. She just know you got money.
So she trying to see, lay that setup. That's true.
I'm very sorry, but I got to address something real quick. Sadia is saying that, you know.
Saida.
She's saying that black men are saying that, you know, black women have so much high standards, and that's why they go to other races and stuff like that. I want everyone to know, like, this. The person I'm with got nothing to do with black. Is not a race thing. You understand? This chick.
As soon as you're not married to a black woman, all of your credit, as far as your opinions, get nullified.
Right. And I just wanted to
pretty. You lying.
Exactly. I said it.
Yes, you did.
You
in the beginning of the conversation.
I did not say dark skin woman just got pretty. They just
yo,
lie.
You foul. He didn't say that. You didn't say that. You didn't say that. He did not say that. You did not say that. Don't set my man up for something like that.
I don't need Delta, right? I can get you to Dubai with the motherfucking A's. I said dark skin women have just started being accepted.
That's crazy.
Yes, they have.
That is definitely crazy.
Yes, they have. We've been in a fucking color war our whole life. Michael Jackson.
You've been in
the fucking
color war. Nobody ain't never say nothing.
Michael
about
Jackson
bleached
his skin.
So let me ask you a question, Star. No one
country.
Has ever said to you, or you never heard in your whole life,
black,
you're pretty
y'all.
For a dark skinned girl. You've never heard that in your whole life.
All right, I did hear that.
Okay. All
right, then.
So that's the point he's making.
He has a certain
fucking point there, man.
Certain levels in life, when you're trying to get to certain things in life, it would have stopped it. It would have.
Back
would've.
In the day, it would have stopped
back
it.
In the day.
Back in the day, you would have had a dark skin
right
spokesmodel for a fashion brand.
Right, I'm saying that shouldn't even be spoken of right now because I haven't experienced that. That comment doesn't even bother me. I just feel like they ignorant and I can just keep it moving.
Ignorant,
that's not something
man.
That.
But
I
that's
entertain.
Just the point. Come on, lie, you dirty right now.
Lie, great. But yeah, let me just address this.
No,
real quick.
We gotta move on.
I want her to understand.
5'2" top.
I want.
Now you wrong, lie.
She is short.
The whole fucking
she is short. But you know what it is though? Like I'm receiving a lot of hate. It's a lot of hate and shade coming my way. And it's like, yo, like
that's something that I'm gonna
why do everyone wanna like you when you taken? But why do everyone wanna like you when you go to the next level?
They like that game.
It's
that
like
game.
It's like, yo, listen, nah, like at the end of the day, get the
if your man didn't propose, a lot of people are accepting babies and not rings. I don't understand.
Let me tell you why. Because a woman feel like once another woman validated you, then now you're worth the risk. Before,
yeah.
When you didn't get that validation, there's a lot of questions behind
you. And I want her to understand, because she just said, oh, black man, what's wrong with a man having a job and a da-da. I got all that. I had a 4.3, boo-boo. I got all that. I'm good over here. But okay. what I'm saying is... Next topic.
Hold on, I got to pull the mic. What I'm saying is this.
Like, when we don't even... Like, listen, man. Honestly... I've been talking to Shorty for a minute. She haven't even asked how much I make yet. We never talk about money. Never.
She's
you hear me?
You.
Never.
Couple things about that. Black girl asked you that on day one.
No, and it's not.
They already Googled you on the first day to see how much you make.
No, they asked you on day one.
What do you do? How much you make? Oh, a black man supposed to pay all the bills.
We're leaving the topic right because we're in the black woman wars. That's a whole nother show.
Fuck out of here.
That's a whole nother show.
How long can this go?
Fuck out of here. I'm not paying all the bills. Fuck out of here, nigga. Split that 50-50, nigga.
Magic, you was about to make a point.
No, I don't want to go on.
Our next topic, because that could have just continued to go left. You know what I'm saying? But Bay Christmas, right? So you know everybody, you know, have bays. You know sometimes bays hasn't reached the level of complete wifey. This might be bay and stuff like that. What's a good gift to buy for the first year for bay? Like before you really know. Like wifey, you know the parameters you might spend on wifey, but you know, when shorty, what you said?
We'll let black go last. They can talk about
it. Lot of these fucking ears, man. I'm telling you.
Could you come on? Let us go to the time. Alright, so what is a good gift to give Bae when it's not that serious yet? It's less than a year and stuff like that. What's a good gift to give?
Just cuffed up.
Next Sunday's Christmas.
How long we been dating for?
Just cuffed up.
It could be, let's say, 3 to 6 months.
3 to 6 months. That's too early.
I'll let you know. I'll let you know.
I'm gonna say, like perfume.
A year?
A bracelet, maybe.
A bracelet.
That's good. Like, first year, bae, like, that's a good, like, you know what I'm saying? My girl, I got her some perfume. She liked this perfume. That's what's up.
What would you like?
What would I like
after first year?
Mm-hmm. Bitch, you buy me a Rolex. Y'all give a fuck.
Rolex, that's not gonna happen.
That's light skin dude attitude.
Realistically, I'll be sure.
I don't ask for much because, good. Like, I'm saying, I don't really ask for much. So, I'll take, like, a pair of sneakers. I'll take a video. If I ain't get the 2K, go pull that 2K up for me. I'll play a little video games here and there. That's a good first year for me. Like, okay, I'll take that one. I'm good with that. You know what I'm saying?
What do you think?
Get this perfume.
I don't want no perfume.
That love spell.
What you want?
That lotion.
After a year, I want a nice wallet.
Okay.
What you mean? A purse?
The first year, I'm not gonna...
Coach.
The first... Hell.
Fucking...
So what type of wallet?
What type of wallet? A Michael Kors. You better go sit down.
I want a nice wallet or a nice piece of jewelry.
Hold on. Is he not in your mouth?
Could
he not in your mouth?
I'll speak.
No, he
can't not in your mouth. You want a wallet or jewelry?
No, he cannot.
You better get some Fridays and go sit the fuck down, motherfucker.
I want a wallet or a nice piece of jewelry.
You getting your canvas painted.
Let Magic.
Those $7 wings.
Let Magic answer the question.
First year?
Mm-hmm.
You said first 6 months of first year? Truthfully, nothing expensive. Mm-hmm. Nothing expensive.
Makes
nothing
sense.
That considers a lot of money.
Mm-hmm. What do you consider a lot of money?
A Gucci wallet.
A Gucci wallet, a lot of money. You're not getting that.
Exactly.
I'm getting that.
No, you're not. I like to listen when people talk.
I'm sorry.
Because I'm listening to you. I'm just saying I like to listen to people vibe. But me personally, material stuff at the first year means nothing.
It doesn't.
It means nothing.
It should be thoughtful stuff.
Because that means I still don't know nothing about you. I could have bought you
exactly.
anything.
Exactly.
So personally, for the first year, for me, it's like a listening process. It's like almost like first year class. Like, and then they want to know what you actually learned those first couple days. So I want to know exactly what you know about me. Have you listened to me talk?
Yeah.
Because by me talking, you should know what I like. That doesn't consist of no money.
Yeah.
I don't want you spending no money on me. Because now, if you're spending money on me, that doesn't mean we're going to be together. Yeah. I don't
it's
waste
thoughtful.
My time.
It's something that made me realize, you know what? She listened to me.
She listened.
She know I have this interest. Yes. It don't got to be expensive. Yes. You know what I'm saying? Yes. All my gifts to my wife was always thoughtful before the price.
Right.
After we got together, then I started buying bags and stuff like that. But before, it was thoughtful.
That's why she's your wife.
Yeah.
Because she wouldn't be your wife if it was always just... any one of us here could spend anything on anybody. It's not a
except for Lyle, cause Lyle broke.
I'm broke. I don't care. Bro. You know what I'm saying?
Half my working motherfucker.
875.
You know what I mean?
So me, you get a check for them fucking ears though. SSI.
Come on, man. Y'all getting on tangent. Let's continue.
Now, why you always trying to shut me down?
No, I'm not shutting you down. Y'all just going on a tangent.
Yeah. So me, man. I don't play no games, bro. And it's love. A chick is gonna have to respect it.
Yeah,
I agree.
She's gonna have to respect it, cause I'm not being an asshole. I'm just saying, bro, babe, listen. You wanna go to if I know you, we was talking. You say, yo, I really really wanna do something the Hamptons and really have like a little day out. And, you know what I mean, something like that.
Yeah.
And that's what you really wanna do. I'm gonna surprise you with that because that's really what you really wanna do, and it costs no money. Yeah. And I'm gonna see where your mind is at by me not spending no money.
Yeah, exactly.
No, but that is money. That's a nice.
Because a lot of them is all about that paper.
All about that paper. Yeah. You know
if you
saying?
Get your girl, if you get one of these girls, one of these motherfucking social media chicks right now, you get them nothing. It's she cheating. She breaking up with you.
She letting people know you ain't crap because you ain't spending no money.
She's about posting everything.
Because truthfully, somebody gonna buy you that purse, and he probably bought his other chick
the same purse.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he probably stole it. Or probably scammed it.
He probably scammed it.
Not even thinking about the dude.
He bought it from a booster.
See, my thing is this:
a booster gave him two for three.
A chick
prices.
Don't care. A chick don't care how you get it.
Yeah.
And that's what I think. That's what I hate when they don't consider that. You understand?
Yeah.
Like that's why my shorty consider it. You know what I mean? If you ain't got it, you ain't got it, nigga. Yeah. You ain't gotta go try to go get it. A chick wants you to go get that. Yeah. She don't care how you go get it. Go put your life on the line. Not much motherfuckers putting their life on the line, getting locked up, trying to hustle to impress a chick.
Yeah.
Dude, just fucking crazy, homie. Yeah. I ain't going to jail. Too much men over there.
Like,
and I don't like oodles and noodles, motherfucker. Fuck wrong with y'all niggas.
Nino Brown talking, dude.
Because
we running time, I'd like to spend a couple minutes chopping it up with DJ Magic.
Yes, sir.
To discuss, you know,
yes,
your
sir.
Process,
yes,
you know, how
the
you
car
came
man,
up.
The van man, the car show man, all that.
All that stuff like that, you know. I first heard of you actually... I heard of you before, but one of the strongest things is like you being in Money and Violence and having stuff like that. You know what I mean? So just discuss, you know, some of your come ups and stuff like that. If you have any advice for up and coming DJs or anything like that.
Yeah,
because
I'm trying to get off the ground.
I got some advice for them too, man.
Listen, but we're not asking you, Black. We asking Black, Magic.
Up and coming DJs with no car, stop.
Listen, Black, let Magic talk.
Top, stop. Up and coming DJs with a bullshit DJ name, stop. Up and coming DJs, you can't get nowhere, stop. Up and coming DJs, you don't got no chain, stop. Up and coming DJs with no bookings, stop. Up and coming DJs, you free on the weekends, stop. Up and coming DJs, you ain't throwing a car show, stop.
Cut this real mic off, man.
Too many DJs out here.
Can we let Magic?
Black and I speak on a regular like this all the time. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Magic.
Yeah.
If you don't got no drop, stop, nigga. Shout out to Young Carter. He coming on his way.
Oh my God. I mean, damn. My story is a long story, man. I started in Brooklyn. I started in school. I was a nerd, actually. I went to private schools all my life. Actually, from high school on to college. And then I came back to Brooklyn, man, and I was always into music. Long story short, again, I was a shy dude, man. I wasn't really into, I wasn't a talker.
So you wasn't, like, Black in everybody's face
not,
and stuff
bro.
Like that?
Definitely was not. Yeah, actually, you know, it would have been good to be around, but I did it. But you know what I'm saying? But I wasn't a talker. Everything with me was with my hands and making money. I had a job. I was always into working and getting a job and actually putting my money back to my brand.
Yeah.
So now I started DJing in Brooklyn, man. I used to get criticized all the time because I was only doing Brooklyn, you know what I mean? But, I, you know, I got, I felt like Brooklyn was the hardest place to get known. I was learning, watching other
DJs. Like,
if
you
can
make it
like
in
that.
Brooklyn, then you make it anywhere.
Right, but
that.
Back then, like, 2000, like, what, five? I came in the game in 03, 04. So that kind of came in late, too. And then I was always in the competition DJ. I wasn't really in the clubs.
Yeah.
So I learned how to talk on a mic from watching these Caribbean dudes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then I started, it took like a year, whatever, whatever. And then I actually started doing parties on my own. But again, I was nervous, man. I was just screaming on the mic. I was trying to, I was mimicking what I seen.
Yeah.
But I always had skills.
Yeah.
You know, a friend of mine brought me out in the scene. And then I started getting parties. And I just started doing that, man. And then people kept telling me, oh, you know. You need to get elsewhere, and I never believed in that, man. I always wanted to capitalize somewhere.
Yeah, but you know that's the New York mentality, right? Because in New York, once you popping in your block on your hood, you don't really care about popping anywhere else.
Yeah, and that was actually hard back then. But then I started doing almost 3-4 parties a night.
Wow.
In a borough.
Yeah.
That was never heard of, bro. I was stopping big dudes from getting booked in a borough.
Yeah.
So I kind of like learned that from an OG. An OG of mine told me, listen, you need to do that. Keep doing that. Then I started getting booked out of the country. Nah, whatever, mm-hmm. whatever. Then it started expanding. But that's how I put money back into myself. Bought me a van. Nobody rapped. Yeah. Nobody did it.
I seen your van around.
You know what I'm saying?
Everybody's
seen
that
van around.
Yeah.
That van being
more
states than people.
Yeah.
Japan tour,
you know what I'm
saying?
And then I started, everything with me from that point on was just branding.
Yeah.
I would never buy clothes. I didn't have no bread.
Yeah.
So I was buying my own shit.
Yeah.
I do my own. Everything with me is branded. I ain't give a fuck. I didn't want to wear nothing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then on and on. And then my name got more big and stuff like that. And then I just learned how to just brand everything. Everything I did was more than brand. You know what I mean?
I think you doing the whole Brooklyn thing was a great thing. Because I feel like a lot of DJs today, all the DJs, right? Mm-hmm. The ones that's popping, the ones that get bookings. Their hood, whatever hood they're from, mm-hmm. like Magic is from the East, and you know he fuck with Flatbush and shit. Those are automatic bookings. All those baby showers, all those weddings, all those birthday parties, all those they're gonna say, hey, I want Magic. And Self is from fucking Fort Greene, so all those Fort Greene motherfuckers, all them baby showers, all them. So
Self was definitely that guy in the city.
Yeah,
I couldn't step.
But you gotta have your hood behind.
I have my hood behind me.
Got.
And you know, it's funny now because I did that. What, like 09, 08, 10? I was Brooklyn. Now people trying to do it now, but it's a different scene now. Like,
it's a different
trying
scene.
To do that back, but I was doing it before.
And it's oversaturated.
There's
so much DJs right now.
It's oversaturated.
Everybody's a DJ.
So then I got on the radio, and then it just kept going, man. But, you know.
One question I wanted to ask is, what was your damn, I made it moment? Or, like, you know, one moment that sticks out to you, like, man, is this love that you never expected to have?
It's two of them, man. And again, man, we can talk. It's two situations. The first one was when I got on Fox 5.
Okay.
And the Fox 5 was good, but then they heard about my van, and they came down to see my van, and they was like, "We never seen that like this. Cause I had hydraulics on my van. I put a lot of money into my brand.
Yeah.
I always was told to do something different. You know what I'm saying?" So then they actually liked it, and they requested it to be there for the week. So that van stayed there for a whole week in Fox Pop Station. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, nah, that I made it that time.
Yeah.
Second time was when I actually was featured on Funkmaster Flex's every Thursday show as a guest DJ.
Okay.
That was it. Once I did that show, the world knew that I was already good.
Man, open up the doors.
It opened up. It
and
was,
that's love
was,
for Flex to put you onto that situation.
No, Mr. C put me on it.
Oh, Mr. C, okay.
Let's stand corrected. Mr. C put me onto that situation.
Mm.
Thank you. And I always, that's always my brother. Hard mm-hmm. times, bad times, whatever. That's my guy. Like, I love that nigga. You know
not
what I'm saying?
Not for nothing. He is a good DJ. After all, even all the bullshit that he went through, he's a good DJ. Like,
I always respected his skills. You know what I'm saying? Everything else, that's your personal business.
That's he comes to my house. And nobody comes to my crib. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, he comes to my house and stuff like that. But he the one that put me on the big dog Pitbulls.
Mm-hmm.
All right? And then he got me on that show.
and I'm my skills. I already know my skills, you know what I'm saying? So I already know I'm gonna go do something, and it was itching me to do this shit. It ain't like now when they get niggas up there and they just went. Nah, it meant something back then in 2010.
Yeah.
When they let us go up there, and I bodied it to the point where Flex was like.
And that's when you first started the car show.
Right. And then at the
2010,
year,
right. And car show started in East New York, bro.
Right, right, right.
The danger spot. I don't know what the fuck we was doing there, but it worked out.
You know what it was? Yeah. I was from all over Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Like, I lived in Bed-Stuy. I moved from Bed-Stuy to Coney Island. Coney Island to Star City. From Star City to Flatbush. From Flatbush to East New York. From Flatbush to East New York to Bronson. So, I had family issues, you know what I'm saying, back then. But, you know, so we did it. We did it anywhere in Brooklyn. It wasn't about not a problem, you know what I'm saying? But then after I got to that point where with the Hot 97, I just wanted to brand everything.
Okay.
So now I do big car shows, own jacket companies, own
sponsored every year.
What's the future for your brand, and what haven't you accomplished that you're looking to accomplish in the next couple of years?
The future for the brand is I'm heavy into businesses and actually investments.
Mm-hmm.
I do that now, and I like speaking to kids and kind of like pointing them in the right direction, basically just to. Because our generation is kind of like is messed up, man. And, you know what I'm saying? And everybody think that we have to do drugs and this, that, and the third to make money. When it's actually you can make legit money, have a legit family, and consistent. Meaning that you don't have to look over your back tomorrow.
Yeah.
Nothing better than to get up and knowing I'm comfortable. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna make this money good. So I talk to kids and help them learn how to invest their money, save, and actually have accounts that actually can raise you more money while you're, God forbid you get sick. God forbid most of these DJs break a leg or break a finger. Mm. How are they gonna make money?
Obamacare.
That's how they gonna take care of themselves. That's not how they gonna make money.
You know what I'm saying? How are you gonna make the money if you, and I'm talking about most of these DJs, like, just think about it.
Most of them are basing everything off of DJing. If they don't DJ, they don't eat.
Multiple
streams of income is the best thing you can have.
Saving income and having it make the interest and learning the interest on how to make the money is the way you have to survive.
Yeah.
Because you cannot, this is a game where you cannot be 50 or 60. You gotta think of it as I'm already about to be 60 tomorrow.
Yeah.
You have to move like that now.
That's one thing I hate about the hip-hop culture, though. It's ageism, right? Like, Jay-Z's still hard and stuff like that, but some people kind of clown Jay-Z because they say
he's older. What happened to Bernard Hopkins last night?
That's different. That's sports. Nah, athletes, nah, you have a window.
Same shit. No one to hang it up, motherfucker.
Jay-Z's
out the game.
Jay-Z's not going to hang it up because he has too much other money for him not to hang it up.
Yeah. He's not going to do an album.
Why would I hang up for him? I'm making...
On an album.
If you know if I hang it up, I still got 10 other ways to make money. Why would I hang it up, nigga?
Yeah.
But it don't make no sense. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like anybody, money. Anybody that's making multiple money, why would I hang up? I got this other money. You're not going to hang up because, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
You're going to look stupid.
Everything is feeding
each other. Yeah, you look stupid if you're not doing nothing else, and then you're not hanging up. Now you're looking like a jackass out here. You know what I'm saying?
All right, we got to wrap it up because our time is coming. We'd like, at this point of the show, people do their shout-outs of something coming up and stuff like that, so you can start it off, Magic.
Oh, man. Shout out to my son that's on the way. That's all I'm shouting at him from the start. Man.
Congrats on that. Blessings.
Bless
up.
Kobe's a healthy boy and all that.
Yeah, man. That's my mind right now, man. And I'm just I'm here for him right now. You know what I'm saying? And my family, man. That's, you know.
Okay, but no shows you want to shout out? I know he's about to shout out Lust and New Year's Eve and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Damn, I got so much things, man. I'm always. Go on my Instagram at IamDJMagic.
Mm-hmm.
Instagram. I got my web series that I got going on. My car web series. I can talk all about that. But it's basically me in a car, interviewing entertainers.
What is it called?
It's called Riding Out.
Okay.
Riding Out, powered by DJ Magic. Shout out to my team.
Okay.
Wes, Tone.
Where can we go see it? Where?
Right now we're putting it on the website, IamDJMagic.com, but it's on YouTube. I'm fixing up my website. So we send out links and things like that. You go on YouTube, Riding Out, DJ Magic Riding Out.
Mm-hmm.
We got that. And I'm doing a boat show next year, a boat and jet ski show.
Is the date ready?
It's not ready yet. Okay. I'm heavy into boats. Mm-hmm.
Don't judge me. I want a boat too. Ain't nothing wrong with that. I'm sorry. You know what I'm saying? That's levels.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That's why I'm picky about who. When that whole the female situation was like, I was like, I'll watch who I bring around my boats.
Nah, I got you.
Car show, next year we're going to do two. It's going to be a tour. We already got Miami set, Connecticut set, Buffalo set. So we got that going on.
I want to check that out.
I got a bunch of things. New Year. I'm always doing something, bro. I'm just blessed and I'm just happy to be here. And,
Facts. Appreciate that.
And we appreciate Magic for coming out. He was supposed to be on the radio. He recorded his show just to come to Brown Holy Water Podcast.
That's love. That's love.
So that was love. Definitely. That was love. Shout out to
Magic. Hot 97, he pre-recorded for us.
Shout yourself out, Star.
So that's not really him on Hot 97. Fuck out of here. He here.
Yo, Lyle's an asshole, man. Go ahead, Star.
Shout out to you guys for having me here tonight. And
Star.
Thanks. Shout out to all the dark-skinned women, despite what Black
we love dark skin women. Ain't nothing better than chocolate.
Saying,
don't put us in that lane.
It's over.
You got to go back and listen again.
I'm going to watch it all over. And that's all.
Amen to you. Shout out to the dude that didn't listen to you. And the bag that you're not going to get for Christmas.
All right,
Lyle, your turn.
I didn't ask for a bag, Black.
Shout out to Lyle. That's it. Handsome15 Instagram, Lyle Brown. You know, Brown Holy Water. Follow the fan page. Shout out to Freak Leak, my designated driver. I think I'm gonna keep getting drunk tonight. It's lit. And also, not for nothing, congratulations to Jerry Cadet.
Yo!
Government.
Salah Government.
Black success, you
Salah
know.
If y'all Brown thought it was,
if y'all thought it was a hoax, I've been talking to him for a while. He really got engaged. You know, his bride's coming over from China anytime.
She Japanese, motherfucker.
Yo,
what the fuck, this motherfucker?
Nah, not for nothing, though. Congratulations. I'm proud of him. I'm glad to see you doing good things, you know. Everybody moving up. Everybody leveling up, man. That's what's up.
Yeah, man.
Brown Holy Water. I'm out.
If you ain't getting a ring, that means you're pussy trash. You know what I mean?
Come on. Let me do my shout-out while I let you close it out, right? Don't associate with that comment he just made. I want to shout-out with the Brown Holy Water brand, at Brown Holy Water. That's the Instagram and the Twitter. Please follow us. Look at the Army Fatigue hat at Brown Holy Water. Merchandise coming soon.
I'm sorry to cut you off, Mar. Also, iTunes, Brown Holy Water, all together. Start following that. If y'all missed the episode tonight, listen in the car. Fuck the... I ain't going to say fuck the Breakfast Club. Breakfast Club is good, but we got better chemistry. It's lit.
Also, you know, support black brands. I'm wearing the Live Life, Love Life. It's not just a lifestyle. It's a way of living. My man, Steiner Woodruff, out of Brooklyn. A brand to support, you know what I'm saying? Also, shout out to my little brother who's going to have his first child any day now. My beautiful niece is coming.
That's love. That's what's up. Big up, big up. Yo, y'all already know what it is. Your boy Black Success, man. Shout out to my fiance. She got 2 carats on that. On that finger, clear stones. You can see right through it. You know what I mean? It's a different kind of budget. You gotta save a little different. You know, but
there's levels to the show.
Yeah, there's levels to it. You know what I mean? VBS everything. So it's just, you know, it's just like, you know, somebody's on security number. It's just a beautiful thing. Like, I feel like a lot of dudes feel like they're gonna be scared to like propose, like they're gonna lose something, like that. You know, like I was born poor. I lose nothing. You understand? Yeah. So, if you love someone and someone is different, you know, I think it's a great thing to make that type of jump. You know, make that jump. All right,
we gotta wrap it up.
The person that you love. Get out of me. Make that jump. Get a ring. Let them know you want a ring.
Yeah.
You ladies want a ring.
We got to wrap it up. Shout out your event before we can go.
If your engagement ring used to be a earring, get the fuck out of here. That nigga don't love you.
We going over our time, bro. We going over our time. Shout out your event.
New Year's Eve, Club Lust, DJ Magic. All
right, shut us up. Brown Holy Water Park, guys. Come get baptized next Sunday at 7 p.m. We lit. We live.
Like, you got them big ass ears, nigga. Fuck out of here, nigga.
You can't make it to the
y'all
show.
Y'all can't bring something
off my phone. I couldn't see nothing off my phone either.
I don't know what's your job.
No, because y'all probably got Wi-Fi.
You couldn't
see it? Yeah, hell yeah.
You don't have unlimited data?
I actually do, boo.
So you should be able to see it.